know that fearsome creatures walk the earth millions of years ago, but that's walking. What swam beneath the waves? Erich Fitzgerald is the Senior Curator of Vertebrate Paleontology at Museums Victoria. Erich and his team have made some big discoveries in the little-known area of prehistoric marine mammals.
The evolution of life on planet Earth is replete with many epics, if you like, of evolution. And one of those recurring themes is that of animals that begin their evolutionary story on land, but then return to water. And arguably one of the greatest examples of this are the whales and dolphins.
Australia is world famous for its beautiful beaches and epic surf breaks. But it's what's underneath the white sand and the wetsuits that, in paleo terms, really counts.
The surf coast of Victoria in Australia has really some critical characteristics that make it an important site for fossil whale discoveries. The first one is that rocks of the right age and type were formed there. And then critically, those waves, the very surf itself that makes the surf coast famous, are pounding those rocks that are exposed and eroding them, showing us more than 20 million years of whale evolution.
Jan Juck is central to research around Australia's ancient marine mammals. It even has its own fossil, the Jangecetus.
The discovery of Jangecetus really shifted our thinking on the origin of baleen whales, the largest animals that have ever lived. It showed us that the earliest baleen whales were not gentle giants, but were relatively tiny, ferocious predators.
The Jangecetus is just one of many significant fossils found on Victoria's surf coast. But how do you find all these fossils? And what do you do with them once you find them?
Most fossils on the surf coast are eroding out of the shore platform under your feet where you walk along the beach. Sometimes we can just carry them away. More often we have to actually excavate rock from the shoreline with heavy equipment like saws and chisels. We all get quite excited even if it's just a single bone or even part of a bone. If we can tell what that animal is, we can look in the same area and hope to find more. What happens next for any fossil is always different. Often we can pick through loose sand and rubble to identify things like small bones and shark's teeth. Sometimes we'll use small air-driven jackhammers to knock away rock from the bone surface.
The beach has always brought people together, and for our team of paleontologists, it's no different.
We can never get out into the field as much as we'd like to. So we like to develop relationships with private collectors and donors who can spend much more time prospecting on the beaches of the surf coast than we're able to. And they'll often contact us when they discover a new find.
Through the work of researchers and citizen scientists, a new light is being shone on Australia's beaches. A light that reflects across millions of years.